Everyone's ready. We'll go right to questions for Coach Hoiberg. Hoiberg. Go ahead. Questions?
I'm good.
Fred, what was your plan on Pickett? He ended up having more turnovers than he usually has. Can you just take us through what the idea was there?
Yeah, we had a couple different coverages on him. He's one of the toughest guys to prepare for in this league just because of his versatility and his ability to take advantage of a mismatch. And, you know, we had different things that we tried to do. We doubled him early, and I thought we had good active hands, which created some turnovers. And first half, you know, I thought we did a good job overall. They shot 33%, although of their 13 field goals, I think 10 of them were threes. And, you know, they just put you in rotation, and they got guys that can shoot it all over the floor. Micah does a great job of getting that floor spaced and, you know, puts you in a heck of a bind with one of the best one-on-one players in the league, and they just pick on guys. So, you know, I thought early, after they went on a 10-0 run, I thought we settled down and made a nice run ourselves. And if we could have made a free throw, it could have been a, you know, one possession or tied game. But it didn't happen. Second half, I thought we came out and made a nice run to pull even, and then they really got it going. And I think they made 14 in their next 18 after we tied it. Our offense was much better in the second half. I thought our movement was really good. He shoot 54%. That should be good enough to at least give yourself a chance. But defensively, you know, we had to change. We went to more of a one-on-one type matchup with Pickett, and obviously he took advantage of that.
Fred, how hard is it to game plan for someone like Andrew Funk, who can be such a threat as a scorer, but is more active off the ball than he is on the ball?
Yeah, he's a guy that, you know, he's got a quick trigger, one of the quickest releases in the league. And when they put he and Lundy on that backside, you know, it's pick your poison when you're in a rotation. And then you have to fly at him and try to run him off. But both those guys have incredibly quick releases. So, you know, really impressed with this team and their ability to shoot it. You watch the Indiana game, it just kind of scares you with what they're capable of doing, hitting 18 threes in that game. But, again, it starts with Pickett. He's the guy, you know, it's getting the ball and creating double teams. Or if you play him one-on-one, he's so gifted and getting to the basket, late shot fakes, getting to the free throw line. But, yeah, Funk got it going early, the four-point play in the first possession, and you know, he never slowed down.
Coach, you knew Penn State was going to go with a small ball lineup at some point in the game where they have four, even five shooters on the floor. What was the game plan going in to defend that, and how do you think you executed that?
Well, we wanted to, you know, first of all, try to take advantage of Derek on the other end, and, you know, we felt we'd have a size advantage. Derek got us going after a slow start, I think hit three baskets in a row to pull us back into it. But, you know, again, that's what they do. They put you in a tough spot, and Dredd does a good job guarding the post, you know, with his size. You know, Derek, I thought we played through the elbow. And, again, our offense was fine is in the second half. We did what we had to do to give ourselves a chance on that end. But, again, defensively, we just couldn't get enough stops. And that's a credit to Penn State and putting those five shooters out on the floor and taking advantage of it.
Penn State's starting big man Kebba Jai was pulled after 5 minutes. What was the game plan to kind of control the paint?
Well, it's been one thing with us not being able to shoot the ball very well this year is scoring in the paint. And we've done a good job for the most part all year outscoring teams. We at Michigan State, even though we got beat, we outscored them by 20 in the paint. That's hard to do against the Tom Izzo team and the Breslin Center. So, you know, we made a concerted effort to get the ball inside or drive it against longer closeouts. Derek has done a great job in the paint. Sam Griesel, you know, with the right matchup, has done a good job in the paint. Second half, it was good to see our guys look for our shooters and get CJ going a little bit and get Casey going a little bit. I thought we took the, you know, the rushed one with the flop. I thought was, you know, we were getting shots off our movement. And, you know, that play where you take a rushed one, you know, I thought was a big play. But, you know, again, our guys compete. They play hard. We'll have more of an update on Emmanuel tomorrow. That certainly was a part of our defensive woes. He's our best perimeter defender, one of the best I've ever coached. And you're already thin with Juwan Gary out of the lineup. So, you know, we'll see what happens with the test. We'll get him scanned tomorrow and hope for the best.
Fred, you guys obviously had a lot of success coming in here last year and playing Penn State. What is different about this year's Penn State team compared to that team?
Well, I just think this team shoots the ball so well. And listen, they had a good team last year. It just that was our one stretch of the season where we had it clicking a little bit. So, you know, they just, again, I say it over and over again, they put you in such a difficult position because of everybody's ability to knock down shots. And, again, they did a great job bringing in some veteran guys and you know, Pickett having to – plan for him is, as I said, one of the toughest things that we'll have to do all year. You know, we'll bounce back. Got another big one here coming up next week with Northwestern.
Anything else for Coach?
Thanks, guys.